All right, we need to go over your homework here in section 4.1, which was in your book on page 420 and 421 here, and actually were a couple there on 422. But questions here on page 420, any of these, or 421, any of this you need to see here. Now's a good time to ask about them. How did you do on the graphing the exponentials here? Did everybody do okay with your shiftings and your reflections? Is everybody all right with those? What about the word problems? Look at number, say, 55 here on page 421. Look at number 55. All right, 55. Suppose that you have $12,000 to invest. So I've got a principal here of $12,000. All right, which investment yields a greater return over 3 years? So they're telling me that time equals 3 years. And the reason why I'm copying this over is they're wanting to know which yields the best investment. This one with a rate of 7% compounded monthly, where n would equal 12, or this one over here where it's at 6.8%, and you're going to be what? Continuously. All right, so we need to calculate both of these, right? So for the first one here, I'm going to use what? 12,000, 1 plus 0.07 over 12 raised to the 12 times 3. And over here, I'm going to have 12,000 e to the 0.0685 times 3. All right, do both of those, and let's see which one of them yields me my best investment here. All right, now you should be able to put both of these in your calculator here, I hope. Now again, for this one, you would want to do 12,000, open parentheses, 1 plus 0.07, divide by 12, close parentheses, hat, open parentheses, 12 times 3, and hit enter. All right. Did y'all get $14,795.11? For the one right here. All right. So for this one, you would need to do what? 12,000, second key, LN, to get your e to the x, 0.0685 times 3, close parentheses, and hit enter. Did y'all get 14,737? Which one of these was the better investment? The first one here, right? And why do you think that was? Because the interest rate was actually a little better here, wasn't it? And that interest rate over time being a little higher is going to give you more of a return than if you were actually compounding it continuously over here. Does everybody see this? Is this what y'all got? Just make sure. All right. Now, any others from the homework here? Any others from the homework on section 4.2? What number? Yeah, 4.1, what did I say? Oh, we ain't got 4.2 yet. Let's see, what else did you have to do here? I think you can do that. Look at one like number 67 over there on page 422. Since we didn't get to do one of these, it says, if the inflation rate is 6%, how much will a house now worth $465,000 be worth in 10 years? And they're giving you the formula up here where S equals C times 1 plus R to the T. And what the S represents here, well, let's go through it. C is the value today. This is your value today. The R here represents the annual inflation rate. T represents what? Time in years. So what is S going to end up giving you? S gives you what? The inflated value T years from now. All right. So on 67, if the inflation rate is 6%, so R here is 6%, which is going to be 0.06. How much will a house now worth? $465,000. So C is $465,000. Be worth in T equals 10. All right. So now this will be S equals $465,000. 1 plus your rate was 0.06 and T is 10. All right, so put that in your calculator there. Y'all should be able to put that one in there. I can't imagine paying $465,000 for a home. So you would end up with $832,744.18. Is that what y'all got? Yeah. So what? Well, your calculator must be. All right, does everybody see this? Cool. Something similar to that, yeah. Now, a couple of years ago here in Bay County, this was about what was happening with property values. But I don't know, certain subdivisions, like the subdivision I live in, property values have bottomed out because there's been so many repossessed homes. So we're like 3 years ago, my house was worth $350,000. Today it's only worth about $210,000. So it's because there's been so many repossessed homes in my subdivision. And it hurts the others. So. All right, but does everybody understand this formula? We all right here? Any other questions here in section 4.1? We all right with section 4.1? This section, I hope you found not to be that bad. Is everybody all right? Cool.